the first one is you gotta make peace with your fellow man. You gotta make peace with one another. You've got to make peace. You know how you make peace with someone? You start speaking words of life to them. You start speaking words of life. The Bible says in Proverbs 18:21, it says life and death is in the power of your tongue. And you can speak words of life. Let me tell you what, John 6:63, Jesus says, it is the Spirit. Somebody say Spirit. Yeah. It's the Spirit. We can't see the Spirit, but it is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh counts for nothing. But then he says, the words I speak unto you, they are Spirit and they are life. You need to understand your words are not just sound, particularly young boys and girls that you put on Facebook and that you post. Your words are not just sound. The Bible says your words are Spirit. God spoke this world into existence by His Spirit. The Bible says in Genesis 1:3, God says, let there be light. And there was light. It came through words. That's how powerful words are. You can build someone up with words, or you can tear somebody down with words. And when it comes to making peace with your fellow man, making peace with your husband, making peace with your wife, or boyfriend or girlfriend, making peace with your best friend in college, it starts with your words. It starts with your words. Let me tell you what, your words are powerful. I wish I had time to really go through this text and show you what Jesus himself is catching hold to words. He's catching hold of them. He's telling us in verses 1 and 2, he says, wherefore there's a great cloud of witnesses watching you. You didn't get here by yourself. You think it was you that went and graduated from Alabama. You know what? You working, you built the business. You think you've done it all. But let me tell you what, there's a great cloud of witnesses. There are people that prayed for you. There are people that fasted for you. Great-granddaddy, grandmama, father and mother prayed for you. When you didn't have two nickels to rub together, somebody was praying for you. And you need to know that. You need to know that because it's easy to stumble. It's easy to become pious. It's easy to become selfish. It's easy to think that I have done it. Listen, not one of us, as I said, we deserve hell and death in the grave, but Jesus came so we to have life. Amen. We deserve it. So I can't treat my brother any kind of way. I can't talk about his wife. I can't say, let me tell you what, James 5:16 says, confess your faults to one another and pray with one another and you will be healed. The effectual prayer of a righteous man or woman availeth much. You know what's wrong with the body of Christ? Many things, but one thing is that I can't confess my faults to my brother because instead of him praying with me, he goes out and talks about me.